Welcome back, Random TV Reviews, your girl Annette.
And your boy, Stanley.
Listen, we had to break out the Empire shirts for this one right here. Claire Huxtable. Yo, Han Paws tried it.
You done lost your mind.
We're going to take you there. Like the song said, help me now, I'll take you there.
I'll take you there.
Absent child. So we start off with this Godfather scene of... And look, Lucia's even got a haircut for the occasion. Look, you got the Lions versus the Dubois. The Lions told the Dubois, look, I know that y'all had something to do about baby Bella turning up missing because y'all got connections all up and through this city.
Yep.
Lucia said, let me tell you something right here. One thing about my family, yeah, we hood, we this, we that. But when we hit, we hit hard. So, Councilman Tay Diggs, mama. I'm gonna tell, got your cookie said, well, if you're froggy, you feel froggy,
jump, leap.
And I said, and Cookie almost came across the table.
She tried to come across it, they hold her down, but she would come across. Yeah.
You know what?
Like, let her go. Let that pit bull go and bite the mess out of her.
She said, listen, y'all don't did the wrong thing. Y'all don't took my grandbaby away from me. And that's something that you ain't gonna do. And by this time, Anika had enough. Hakeem couldn't even show up. He was just too emotional to show up. But Anika said, listen, all I want is my baby back.
I don't care who right, who wrong, who did what did. I want Bella back.
So old Claire Huxtable gonna turn around and look at her like, you know, I'm so sorry that your baby was taken, but I assure you that me and my family had nothing to do with it. But did you catch Councilman Tay Diggs looking over there at his mama like, are you sure?
Sure, yeah.
That we are 100% clean in this? I said, I don't know.
His mama is conniving.
So not only is the baby missing from the Lion family, the baby's just missing out the CPS records, just period. The baby just can't disappear.
Just can't find her nowhere. Where they do that at?
So Hakeem and Anika went up there looking for the baby. They can't find nothing.
That's supposed to be public record?
No, not that.
I mean, you know what I mean? Like, public record to the goddamn Lisa Thursday. He should have a database in that goddamn Cadillac that he can go in there and pull it up to see where that baby at.
Well, Thursday told the family, after they left from there and they can't find this baby, Thursday said, listen, what y'all gonna need to do is distance yourselves away from the situation.
Yeah, y'all need to disperse. Too many black people in one spot. Y'all need to disperse.
And y'all don't look, he said, y'all don't look good as a unit on paper. All of y'all is unfit. Mama over there laughing. I said, Mama Lucia, what you laughing at?
She said, I told y'all, I knew it.
I told you y'all was unfit.
So there's, we need to go ahead and get this divorce expedited. You know, they'll make it look a lot better so we can expedite this process so we can help get this baby back. Like, what?
A nigga said, let's do it. I said, I'm glad you understood all of that because I'm trying to tell y'all, when we first met Thursday, that accent was not there. From somebody that has an accent, I would have picked up on that. That accent was not there.
Well, maybe his suits was so loud that you couldn't hear it.
Oh, my God.
I remember the first time we seen him, he come around that corner in that blue Cadillac, boy.
But I'm going to be honest with you. When we first met Thursday, we thought Thursday, well, we the season ain't over. I thought that Thursday was going to be the one that's going to do Lucia's it. But he come to find out, he rolled out.
Yeah, he.
Who would have thought you met your good lawyer up in the jailhouse?
Yeah.
Hello. People meet their husbands there too, so I guess it can happen.
Yep.
So Lucia's right. You know him and Jamal are supposed to be working together on this song and whatnot. Now we have a little problem here because we got the same song that's supposed to be on both records, which is just as stupid as can be. Now they gotta have a meeting of the minds of who gonna do what and who gonna humble themselves. Mm-hmm. Well, we know Lucius is not gonna be the one to humble himself.
Nah.
You got to show him better than you can tell him.
Exactly.
So Lucius gonna bring cereal eater. What's his name? Tariq.
The dude from the studio shack.
Yeah, the one that eat all the cereal all the time.
Yeah.
Brought him over talking about some. Hey, I got this dude. As soon as he released, he gonna come over here. He gonna spit fire, the fire that we need to complete this album or whatever. What a track.
I was like, no, we don't need none of that.
He said, get out. So we dealing with the jailbirds again. He said, no, not like that. He was shot
four times. Allegedly.
How you allegedly get shot four times?
Either you got shot or you didn't.
Well, when the dude comes up in there, it's my boy Fetty Wap. He coming in there telling us, yo. I'm here, bro. Look, he said, look, all I need is my pills.
Yeah, give me my pain pill right now.
Look, did y'all see Jamal start to fiend when he saw them pills?
Yeah, he was like,
come on back in. Come on back.
It looked like he wanted to say, hey, bro, can you throw me one of them pills real quick?
Look.
Matter of fact, just go and throw it in the air. Go.
You stupid. So Fetty Wap gets up there and he does what Fetty Wap does. He over there just spitting fire, whatever, huh? And all of a sudden, I said, what kind of shirt he got on?
Do he got
blood stains on his shirt?
He bleeding through where he got shot at.
He over there just spitting. Lucia says, see, that's what I'm talking about.
He willing to die for this skit.
And that's the kind of raw passion that you need to be able to finish a track like this. You need that hood raw. Jamal said, bump this. Hello. Hey, my name's Jamal. How many of y'all in here done been shot before? Everybody said.
Everybody said for Lucius.
He says, so, you're the only one that has all this stuff to say about being rough, rugged, and living in the hood, living in the streets, being shot or whatever. But you the only one up in here ain't been shot. Take it from somebody that has known that pain, that took a bullet for their father. Trust me. They put the track on and everybody in there was like,
It was tight.
We woke up in booty smooth.
It was tight.
And Lucia said, all right, I hear you. Yeah. Stop being, you know. So then we see, oh Lord. This scene right here scared the hell out of me. Because I wasn't ready for it. But Anika's sitting there in her sorrows, crying her little eyes out or whatever. And we see this figure standing at the door. And the door slammed.
But she thought it was Lucius.
She thought it was Lulu. But it was Cuckoo.
Yeah.
That daggone Andre just came running at her like, get out.
Yep.
But he didn't turn. He just went straight into her. And he said, I owe you one.
I owe you one. You killed my wife and my baby. You gonna pay.
You gonna suffer. And took her, slammed her on
it. They were choking her.
And she said, do it. Do what you gotta do. I have sold my soul to be in this family.
Yes.
Just do what you got to do. I'm done. I'm done fighting it. I'm done with y'all lying. All y'all crazy. And I thought Andre's gonna have a little some sympathy for her. And he said, oh. You gonna pay?
Mm-hmm. He said, suffer.
And walked out. I said, Andre, take your meds, bruh.
He ain't took his medicine in 30 days. And his crazy is on a whole nother level tonight.
And you know his kind of crazy that when that prescription run out, they ain't gonna call it into the pharmacy.
Nah, you gotta go back to the doctor.
So he can look at you and be like,
yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, how have you been feeling?
Like shoot, the way Andre been, all he got to do is take a freaking video on his phone and send it to the doctor. He going to fulfill that prescription. Because the doctor probably don't even want him to come back.
Look, his video call will be like this. Hey, doc. It's like, okay, whatever. So, Cookie, she ends up getting this meeting with the guys from Vegas. I can't remember the guy's
DeMarco.
Name. DeMarco. She's basically trying to undermine Lucius.
And, as always.
And I don't even know why they try. And instead of doing Inferno, let's take when Cookie meets Lucius to Vegas and da 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 da.
But anyway.
So she sold it to the guy. She was like, look, at the end of the day, everybody wants this. They want the storyline of how we did Empire.
We
want the visual library. You've seen Lemonade, don't you? It's going to be something like that. And you know, Cushions is all trending on Twitter and IG. You know, let's make it do what it do. And he said, so everybody is in on this? Everybody?
Even Lucius?
Andre said, no.
Nope, I'm not doing a deal with Lucius. I'm not going to do it. He's a liar. He's a snake. He's the devil. I ain't doing business with him.
Everybody said, Cookie said, don't worry about him. You know, that's my son.
It's all good.
Lucius is going to be in on this.
But every time...
Andre went off.
But every time they try to exclude Lucius out of a deal... The person that is doing the deal with always want Lucius to be a part of it because he the heart, unfortunately, He the heart and soul of the company.
Which speaks a lot.
Yeah, which speaks a lot. He's a legend. He started the company. His music was the one that got it off the ground. So you eliminate him,
you ain't got nothing. Really, for real, mm-hmm. for real. So then
he know that too.
Mm-hmm. So after the meeting was over with, because the dude looked at Cookie, and he said something, but basically he was saying crazy as hell. Cookie confronts Andre, said, "Don't you ever in your everlasting
life,
crazy life, do that in front of people." And Andre, he clocked her, and I'm glad that he said what he said. He said, "Listen, what you do is you always say that you're here for the family. Mm-hmm. You want to do everything for the family, but at the end of the day, he gets in your head, and you end up doing things the way he does it that benefits Lucius, and I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired."
Mm-hmm.
And then this is the part that went crazy. She said, "Listen, what I'm doing is going to benefit the family, and we're going to do it this way, and boy, shut up." So Nessa decided that she wanna
put her two cents in it.
She said, "What about the family? Because I'm not a part of the family, and it doesn't look like there's a place for me in this new plan. So listen, what you need to do is stop treating your son like he's a little Nessa. Boy. That is a grown man." That, and the third.
Shut up, Nessa.
Cookie looked at Andre and said, "Son, forgive me for what I'm about to do."
Bah! She smacked the Skittles out of her. She tasted the rainbow tonight. Matter of fact, she ain't got no more taste. She smacked the taste out of her. She ain't come back and do nothing either.
She said that, "Don't you ever come between me and my son." And she carried on with the conversation as if she ain't never slapped him.
Yep.
And then told her, said, "The next time, hold your mouth.
Hold your mouth, B."
I said, like James said, Cookie!
I would expect that. I would expect that.
I said,
but lesson learned. When it ain't about you and your business, keep your mouth shut. You can avoid, a lot of people in this world could avoid a whole lot of backhand slaps and front hand slaps and punches to the face if they only kept this shut right here. That's why the Bible says it's best for you to listen than to talk.
Slow to speak.
Yeah, be quick to listen and slow to speak, because your mouth can get your A whooped. Fast.
Like my mom said, don't let your alligator hind parts get your hummingbird A in trouble now.
Whatever that means, but
we knew what it meant.
We know
shut
what it
up.
Keep your lips shut.
Now, Nessa has finally seen the Dre that we all have witnessed before, the one that was falling around in mm-hmm. the conference room, throwing basketballs around and flipping around. She has seen that Andre, and she confronts Andre and she said, "Listen, I got it. I know what this was all about. You needed a new artist, somebody that was popping, somebody that could take mm-hmm. your career to the next level, somebody that you could control. But baby, I'm not that one." And he said, "You know what? You could have been lucky." She was like, no. "You do business this way. Juliana came around. You were sniffing up at her. This happened. This is how." He said, "I told you. This is how I do business. She was like, "But this ain't how you going to do it with me." He said, "You could have been lucky. You could have been the lucky one." She said, "What?" He tried to kiss up on her, and she was just fighting the mess out of him.
Bah,
and
bah.
You know, when Andre is in that, he just... I said...
He ain't feel none of them punches.
I said, when she go back and tell Shine this, Andre, you gonna see an enemy in the lichens that you ain't never seen before.
Well, I think Andre ready to fight Shine anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah, because your mama back when they were trying to do the business deal, and Andre was like, "Shine, you need to think big. You think smart. You got that up here. You got that up here."
He said, "Andre, not Dre.
Andre,
I'm gonna need you
to bring your voice down a little bit."
I said, "So you seeing it too, Sean?" Sean looked at him like, "What have I gotten myself into?"
Andre done turned into Kanye. That's who he is. That's,
oh, God.
That's Kanye right there.
Come out the sunken place. We
ain't heard nothing else from freaking Kanye since that little episode when he went and talked to Donald Trump.
Somebody said he went and got reprogrammed.
Freaking, I'm sorry, what you call him?
Fanta Face.
Yeah.
Fanta Face and Cheeto Dust. So, Taye Diggs and his mama are exiting a meeting. They're talking to some white guy. I probably know him, but I don't know him at the moment. And
don't even matter.
It don't matter. But what had happened was, Casper Taye Diggs said, "Hey, mama, I'm so sorry about what's going on with baby Bella. I'm just so happy that we don't have anything to do with it. We're clean, right, mama?"
Right, mama.
She said, "Listen, son, our hands are clean. But I can't say that I have 100% sympathy for this family. And all of a sudden, we see a whole bunch of stands of Hakeem's come rolling through talking about some free baby Bella. Because he was on something live, going off about the baby. So they done found out where them jokers at, and they basically like, look, get this baby back to her parents, so, and we'll let you walk away with your life.
So the power of social media, boy. Yeah.
Now, this scene right here confused me. Mama Lucius was in the baby's room, in the medicine cabinet. Why is there a medicine cabinet in the baby's room?
Yeah, why?
Because it's rich people stuff. And she was just rubbing her neck. And I said, oh, she putting her oil of Olay on, child. Go ahead with it.
She rubbed, you know, yeah.
Old secret Noxzema, whatever. That stuff still work, I'm trying to tell you. And I said, and then when Lucius walked in, she got scared.
And she was hiding.
And she hid the container back. And I said, is she putting butt paste on the neck? I mean, what's going on?
What's happening here?
Well, she turns around and she talks to Lucius. And Lucius was telling her, look, you know I'm a bad person. I know that I made some mistakes and maybe my pride got in the way and that's why this baby's not here and blah, 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 blah. And he asked his mama, said, Mom, do you think I'm a bad father?
No, he said, do you think I'm a good father? She said, you a bad person.
He ain't even a good person. Let's start there. And then she ended up going ahead and closing the cabinet. And that's when we saw that it was skin lightening cream. And I said,
why is you hiding that from her? I mean, from him.
What's going? Why is it in the baby's room?
It makes no sense.
I hope they make some kind of sense out of this.
Yeah,
a little
please,
later on.
Because I'm confused. Because I'm like, that's something that could have been in her room on her dresser, and she can rub all she wants stuff on her goddamn neck.
Unless it was in a, you know, it was something else in a container. Maybe she had some of that hemp oil up in there, and she in there just getting high as hell. I don't know. So. She come back in the room with a box of pictures, and she showed Lucius the pictures of his father, and, you know, kind of looked like him. I said, oh, that was a pretty good matchup.
Yeah.
So close then, enough. Lucius decided, hey, he gonna take these pictures back to the studio and blow them up and have them as part of an inspiration for Jamal to go ahead and finish up the track, because he said, I've been humbled.
I think
I'm gonna do it
your
way.
You blow past this, but I think his mom about to try to kill him again.
You said that.
Was being extra nice to him and kissed him on the forehead.
I missed the forehead kiss.
Yeah, she kissed him on the forehead.
I missed that one.
So I'm like, wait a minute, you having to turn around like shimmering lights?
Yeah.
I doubt it though. I doubt it.
I don't know. Ever since she been in that house, the change in environment, Mama Lucius ain't really went off. Except for when she tried to cut him. When she tried to feed him that kid.
Because her freaking eyes been on freaking Anika. That's who she wanted to kill. Anika first, and Lucia second.
So then, Cookie decides, hey, because her and Sean was talking about this baby, and they had a plan. I didn't know what the plan was, but over at the laundromat, they beating a skit.
Out of councilman.
They got Tay Diggs in the back just whooping up on that Trick Gilliam.
Man, he looked like Jim Crow up in there when he was in that basement with Candace. Awesome. With Candace down. Getting his tail whooped.
Cookie says, so your mama said that I was hood. She said that I was ghetto.
She was right.
I am all of that. And then some. You mess with my grandbaby. Bring me back my grandbaby. He's talking about something. Pineapples. I don't have your grandbaby.
I didn't do it. We didn't do it.
I said, She said, well, tell your mama. She basically called this war. Here it is.
It's on.
And she said, continue on. And they continue to whoop his hind paws.
Tore his hind paws up.
And then we see Cookie. She goes from there to explaining this Vegas deal to Lucius. And I said, why?
Why would you tell him? But she had to tell him. Because that was a part of the deal. So but usually she can win him over.
She can finesse it a little better than that.
Yeah, but this time it didn't work because the second devil imp come walking in the room.
Yeah, so while she's trying to explain it to him, you can already tell that he don't got wind of what she tried to do. And he said, no, we're not going to do Cookie Man Lucius. We're going to do Inferno. And here comes Juliana. My people called and told me that there was a secret meeting. And I decided to fly back in to check it out and see what the hell was going on for my goddamn self. So Cookie looks at Lucius and says, so this is what this is about. Your trade-off. Okay, I got you. She said, you know what? I did 17 years for you. And Juliana said, and we thank you. And I'll take it from here.
I just knew. I just knew she was just going to just charge at her and whoop her tail so bad up in there. I was waiting on it. I was like, Cookie. I think the only thing that saved her, because Lucius was in there. If Lucius
that would have been even better.
If Lucius hadn't been in there, she would have whooped her tail up and down that goddamn office.
And that would have been the perfect time. Didn't we forget what she did to Lucius?
That's what I'm talking about.
In that off up and down empire.
But she still got a soft spot for him, see? Because she knew if she jumped up over there, he was going to put her up off of him. So she wasn't going to be able to whoop her tail like she wanted to.
I take my chances.
But she going to catch her by herself walking in the hallway. And she gonna put it on her arm parts. Watch what I tell you.
I don't know where did I get that brownie under my nails, but I don't know about it.
So she got a freaking a whooping in the waiting from goddamn Cookie. Watch what I tell you.
Now this, right here, I'm gonna close y'all out right. We see the Casimir Tay Diggs, however way he got kidnapped in the first place. They never showed us that, but he got released.
They let him go.
And his mama is over there just, you know, bandaging his wounds and all of this good stuff. And she starts ringing this bell. And she said, ting-a-ling-a-ling. And when Casimir Tay Diggs' eyes pan this way and they got big, I said, you better not. And here comes baby Bella being strolled in by the housekeeper.
I say, y'all, you's a dirty somebody, boy. You's a dirty somebody.
Mama said, welcome the newest member of the Dubois family. They messed up the life of one of ours, so we took one of theirs.
I was like, did you just see what they just did to your son? You see him sitting, he barely alive.
And you took a whole baby?
And you took the baby, and they finally, you took that baby? Oh.
But yet can't nobody find the baby in the CPS
records? Oh, hell. We knew she had something to do with it.
But I was trying to put it on Andre, though.
Like, how in the world can you get the baby that fast?
But I'm still thinking maybe Andre had something to do with it, though. I don't know. All I know is.
Andre do got some stuff cooking, though, because he determined he going to take Lucius down. One way or the other.
It was good. It seemed like this episode lasted forever, though.
Yeah, it seemed like it was a long...
I said, that guy doing Hakeem is all messed up. He done put all his people out. Andre going crazy again.
But
Mama told him, said, call your doctor and get your meds straight.
But that's how it is, though. When you change your life, you expect for everybody else around you change your life. And everybody else supposed to get it together.
And you're judging everybody.
Now you don't smoke cigarettes and you don't drink liquor no more. Now you get around everybody else, you judging them, saying you need to stop drinking and smoking, man. You just quit yesterday.
The pack I'm smoking on you bought.
Yeah. And now you coming up here trying to get us to stop when you just stopped yesterday.
All right, y'all. Straight from the VA.
The dirty, dirty South. Two up, two down. Holla.